So apparently, my sister said the other day that the next door neighbour's girl got attacked. And she's a slight thing, she's 14 now. Blonde, wavy hair sort of thing. And she's been independent and coming home from a mate's Halloween night. And there was a top broad meter, Woodford Green. There's the Green and the Castle Pub. Crowd of black hues, dark hues, and she's got attacked by a crowd of hues. And they took a mobile phone, and a boots, and a bag. Apparently she didn't want to let go of the bag, so they had to beat her up a bit first before they took it. I've had bad incidents when I was young, but it's not very nice. I don't think I've actually had my mobile phone, my bag and my boots stolen though. I think I've had a rough time here and there, you know, sort of. Because it's life, isn't it? It's like school, it's like spills over into like a rough life outside. More of a threatening, menacing, violent sort of thing, but I haven't had my boots stolen. So that's not nice. And Phil Willis was on last night on Newsnight, and he's saying, Paxman now, was it Paxo? He said, so how many have you let in then? Something like that, since 79. And Woolly was being a bit woolly, and he's saying, what do you mean, the ones that have gone home? Paxman's going, huh? You mean the ones that have gone home? He said, no, the ones that stayed here. And Woolly goes, what, the ones that have gone back to Poland or the ones that have gone over to Spain? Paxman scratched his head, what's he got about? Yeah. So the Home Secretary is Alan Johnson now. The one, the professor, that one. And he said recently, we've made mistakes over immigration. And Sir Andrew Green of Migration Watch has said, yeah, about 3 million immigrants too late. That apology. So basically the whole 12 years have been in them, messing about. And they're saying, no, it's the other administration, no. There's other people saying, no, they've all come in on your watch. And that's how it goes. But it's a big giveaway, though, because that neither bloke who worked for the government with back in the Blair days said that it was their policy to actually rub the right-wing nose in multiculturalism. So, you know, deliberately have a loose policy. It wasn't an accident. So Alan Johnson is saying it's an accident and it's somebody else's fault. And now the genuine concerns are real, that it is over the top. But, yeah, that's all very well saying that now, but it's his government's been in power these last time. Let all the extra in and been... that's crazy. They went crazy. And... I don't know. It just seemed like London's gone to me. It's like London was some people white there, and now they're not, they're all different culture there now. London's gone. I think it's like Arlo's one of the last holdouts, really, of white people in this country. Feels like it, near London. But I think Arlo will go under soon. And then that's it, I think, around here. Perhaps it's cultures to places out there you got left then. But if the main people, where you have houses and kids, is London, and that's gone. So, but they keep telling me ethnic people are a minority. I don't see it. It looks more like 50-50. I don't know. Anyway, he's going to save the banks now. No, he's been told to save the banks, was he? Well, he could pull out of Europe. Anyway, Gordon Brown's going to break up the banks now. So it's great, because we haven't got to do Lloyd's bad debt as well, but Lloyd's just didn't want to do their bad debt anyway. Didn't want to get taken over by becoming that much. But it's all Scottish banks, really, like Northern Rock, Royal Bank of Scotland. It's all the Scotland. And of course, Gordon Brown's going to bail out his Scottish mates, and because he's Scottish. Actually, English have to put in their pocket. But Europe said, oh, it's a monopoly now, so you can't do it. So you've got to break up your Royal Bank of Scotland and sack everybody. So we put all this money in, multi-billions in, to save Royal Bank of Scotland and save all these jobs. And Europe's coming and said, no, it's a monopoly, sack everybody. So they're going to sack 4,000 people. So that's odd. And it's going to cost us more money to do it, because it means we've got to break everything up and all stuff like that. So that's not very clear, that's very peculiar, because if the government's owning banks, the government can't say, Europe can't say that government's a monopoly. That don't sound right. So it's like saying, because the government just owns stuff, don't they? Like they own this, they own that. I think Europe's got to say, oh, the British government, you're quite a monopoly, you have to break yourself up, you know, you have to go to little departments, little towns. Seems like interfering to me. But that's the way we're going. Oh well.